Today we start a new chapter, chapter 5, that is food and health. Already you know in standard 4, one chapter was there, food. Again we will learn in this chapter, food and health. So, first of all we discuss what is food. Food is a substance that contains some essential material for which our body requires. That is why we take food. What are these essential substances present in food? Those essential substances are called nutrients. Those nutrients are required by our body. Then again, another question arises. What are these nutrients which are present in our food? We take all those food to get all type of nutrients. These are the essential components present in our food that we need. Clear? So what are these nutrients? The nutrients are already we discussed in standard 4. Carbohydrate, proteins, vitamins, minerals, fat and rough edge. Clear? Because all these 6 nutrients are required for our body. That is why we take different type of food in our daily life. Okay, then we discuss what is the balanced diet. Balanced diet already we discussed in standard 4. Balanced diet is the diet in which all the six nutrients are present in proper amount. What are these? Carbohydrate, protein, fat, vitamins, minerals, all are present in proper amount in our balanced diet. That is why we take balanced diet in our daily life. How will we select a balanced diet? So before going to balanced diet, another thing you listen, that is healthy eating pyramid. So if you know what is healthy eating pyramid, then we can select a balanced diet for your life. Okay, so here you see another chart. It is given healthy eating pyramid. It is mentioned here. So when we select a diet, in our diet, which type of food is maximum we take? That is cereals, breads, and you take all rice, chapati, or your bread. You generally take bread. All type of food maximum quantity in our plate. Okay. So next is vegetable and fruits. These are moderate quantity. We need vegetable and fruits in our daily diet more amount. Then the third, just above the vegetable and fruits, that is milk and milk product, cheese, fish, meat. Oh, these are in moderate quantity, not too much. Then at the top of this pyramid, that is sweet, sugar, oil, ghee, butter. So these are very less quantity. That is why we need, when we select a balanced diet for our life, so we have to see this pyramid. If you daily observe this pyramid and according to the pyramid, healthy eating pyramid, if you take balanced diet, then your diet will be proper and balanced, and you will be healthy and fit in your life. Okay, students. Then what is the difference between how our health is depends upon food that we take. If you do not take proper amount as well as a proper food, proper nutritious food, then definitely we will face some certain problem. Then what is health? So health is a physical and a mental well-being of our body. For maintaining, everybody wants to maintain good health, good physical health, good mental health. That is why during the daytime we are taking different type of food. So if you, what are the other things we have to, apart from this food, what are the other things we have to take care to maintain our good health? So other thing what are required for good health are, first thing is balanced diet, second one is physical exercise, third one is proper rest. Daily you have to take 7-8 hour rest. Okay, then fourth one is your personal hygiene. We are daily bathing. When you are bathing, you should use shampoo, soap like substances. Then another very important fifth one is, we should maintain our surrounding neat and clean so that we will be healthy and fit forever. Okay, if we do not follow, if you do not take balanced diet, or if you are not following healthy eating pyramid while you are taking food, definitely you will be in bad health. If you have a bad health, we call this is disease. Then what is the definition of a disease? Disease is the abnormalities or defect found in our body, that is called disease. If your body is not conducting, you are not doing any work properly, your body has something problem, then you say that you are having certain diseases. Okay, now generally in our life we are suffering two types of diseases. One type of diseases are caused due to some disease causing germ, and another type of disease are due to lack of nutrients in our diet. Okay, but in this chapter, that is food and health, here only we discuss the disease those are due to lack of a nutrient in our diet. Lack of nutrient means, again I am reminding you, lack of a carbohydrate, protein, fat, vitamins, minerals. Okay, in this chapter we will discuss about all those things. Now students, we will discuss about some deficiency disease. First deficiency disease we suffered by due to lack of a carbohydrate and a protein in our diet. If we take less amount of a carbohydrate and a protein in our diet, then what disease in which we suffered? Okay, so how will you know that a child or a person is suffered in a deficiency of a carbohydrate and a protein diseases? If the child is not growing according to his age, improper growth, if child's skin is scaly skin, eyes are sunken, just like old people, the skins are just like folded, a child is having dry or scaly skin, eyes are inside the eye socket, the eyeball is remain inside the eye socket. So these are the symptoms of a carbohydrate and protein deficiency disease. Another symptom, that child is very weak. He is unable to do any physical activity like sports. He or she will not participate in that. If he is walking or running for some time, for 5 minutes, immediately he gets tired. So these are all the symptoms of a carbohydrate and a protein deficiency disease. Now we see these are the pulses which is rich in protein. These are the sources of carbohydrate, potato, rice, wheat, sugarcane. These are the sources of carbohydrate. Clear, pulses, milk, egg, fish, soybean, all type of dal, if a child is taking, then this type of a disease, means deficiency disease of a carbohydrate and a protein, will not happen to that child. Okay students, next, another deficiency disease is due to minerals. Now we discuss what are the deficiency disease due to lack of minerals. So first mineral is iron. The deficiency disease due to lack of iron in our diet is anemia. During anemia, or how will you know that a child is suffering in anemia? If that child is very weak, look weak and pale in the body color, means if you see is whitish, pale means whitish, body appearance little bit whitish, and also easily tired, that child get tired easily, and his body or her body is prone to infection. Today common cold happen, after 1 week another dysentery will happen, another 1 week or after few days another cholera will happen. So if that type of a disease frequently occurring in a child, we call that child definitely suffering in iron deficiency disease or anemia. In anemia, what will happen? In our blood, one important red component is present, that is called hemoglobin. Actually, that hemoglobin carry oxygen from our body. When we breathe in, oxygen we take from the lungs. This hemoglobin, which is a red color pigment present in our blood, that carry that oxygen to our each and every part of our body, so that our body can get proper amount of energy to do work. That hemoglobin is formed by iron. Iron helps for the formation of hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is present in our blood. Which component of blood? That is called RBC. RBC. So in RBC, RBC is a spherical structure. RBC is a spherical structure. RBC are red blood cell. Okay? These are red because of hemoglobin is present. Hemoglobin is made by due to iron in our diet. So definitely you have to take iron in our diet to avoid anemia. So during anemia, what will happen? The hemoglobin is not formed proper amount. So RBC is lacking hemoglobin. So RBC lose the carrying oxygen ability from lungs to different part of our body. Okay, students, these are the sources of iron. If you take nuts, castor nut, ground nut, if you take, so all these are the nuts, okay, we take in our diet, then we will not suffer any iron deficiency disease. And another one is, you see, so these are the sprouted seed. So if you take sprouted seed, definitely you will not suffer any iron deficiency disease. If you take, what is this, apple. Daily, if you take one on apple, then you will not suffer any iron deficiency disease like anemia. Okay, so next, now we discuss another deficiency disease due to lack of iodine in our diet that causes a disease called goiter. How will you know that a child is suffered in a goiter? So first symptom of a goiter is swelling at neck region, retarded growth. Third one is mental disorder. If we find all these three symptoms in anybody or any person or any child, then we call that person or that child is suffering a goiter. Okay, how will we avoid that goiter or avoid deficiency of iodine? If you take iodized salt, all your food item, if iodized salt is prepared, definitely you can avoid that. Other than that, seafood like fishes or prawns you can use, then you can avoid this type of diseases. Okay, now we discuss the vitamin deficiency disease. Okay, you know that what are the main vitamins present in our food? Vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C and vitamin D. So one by one, now we will discuss what are the diseases caused due to lack of vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C and vitamin D. Lack of vitamin A, if you are not taking proper amount of vitamin A, then first disease due to lack of vitamin A is night blindness. Okay, this is the disease is due to lack of vitamin A in our diet. What are the symptoms of night blindness? The child unable to see in a dim light. The second symptom is the skin becomes very scaly and eye looks very dull. Their hair is very light and thin. Okay, these are the symptoms of a night blindness. How will you avoid विटामिन ए डेफिशिएंसी डिजीज इफ यू टेक ऑल द ग्रीन वेजिटेबल्स एंड ग्रीन लीफ वेजिटेबल. ग्रीन लीफ वेजिटेबल्स मीन्स ऑल टाइप ऑफ साग, जनरली वी कॉल्ड साग ग्रीन लीफ वेजिटेबल. एंड ग्रीन वेजिटेबल ऑल व्हाट एवर अवेलेबल इन आवर मार्केट, इफ यू टेक कैरोट, टमाटो, रेडिश, इफ यू टेक ऑल दिस टाइप ऑफ फूड, देन यू कैन अवॉइड दिस नाइट ब्लाइंडनेस, विटामिन ए डेफिशिएंसी डिजीज. दीज आर सम वेजिटेबल्स इफ यू टेक इन अवर डाइट देन वी कैन अवॉइड विटामिन ए डेफिशिएंसी डिजीज. Now you see, what is this? It is a milk. Now, this milk is a complete food. Okay? If you take milk, you can avoid certain disease like vitamin A deficiency disease, vitamin B deficiency disease, vitamin D, mineral like calcium, phosphorus are found in milk. Your iron is also present in your milk. So you can avoid, if you take regularly, if you drink milk regularly, then you can avoid most of the vitamin and mineral deficiency disease. So milk is a very important food in our diet. Okay. Now, next vitamin deficiency disease is, that is vitamin B. Vitamin B. Due to vitamin B, the disease caused is very, very, what are the symptoms of a beriberi? Child looks severely weak. Very weak. Child looks very weak. This is the first symptom. And the second symptom is body part may paralyzed. These two are the symptoms of beriberi. How will you avoid this type of diseases? Beriberi diseases. So if you take green vegetable, again green vegetable, lot of green vegetable if you take, milk you take, chicken, egg, if you take, you can avoid nuts you take, then you can avoid beriberi. Okay? Then another deficiency disease, that is vitamin C. Vitamin C deficiency disease is scurvy. Scurvy. How will you know that a child or a person is suffered in scurvy? If the gums are swollen gums, and when we are doing brushing at that time, bloods are coming out, so that is a symptom of a scurvy. Clear? If that happen of any person having some joint pain, that are also the symptom of a scurvy. Okay, then how will you avoid this scurvy or vitamin C deficiency disease? If you take tomato, orange, lemon, amla is a seasonal fruits, you know, amla is a seasonal fruits during summer season. During winter season we can get amla in the market, but lemon whole year, lemon and orange we can get. These two are very rich source of vitamin C. Okay, if you take this type of food, then you can avoid scurvy. Okay, now we discuss another deficiency disease is due to vitamin, that is vitamin D. What is the name of that disease? Rickets. Vitamin D deficiency is rickets. What are the symptoms of rickets? The leg becomes bow leg. How? You see, I am standing here straight. If a child is suffering in rickets, childhood like this, that is called bow leg. Then if either like this, that is called knee knock. When a child will walk like this, that is called knee knock. Knee knock or bow leg, these are the two symptoms of rickets. So it is a very dangerous disease. Because of this, if a child suffers any rickets, we cannot correct it. We cannot rectify it. It will remain with that person throughout his life as a disabled person. Okay, our bone becomes very weak, soft and fragile. Our bone becomes weak, porous, soft and fragile. Even if you fell down from a small height also, 2 or 3 foot high, your bone became broke down. Okay, that bone is very soft, porous and fragile due to lack of vitamin D in your dear students, now you see, in vitamin D and calcium phosphorus, there are two minerals, that is calcium and phosphorus, and one is vitamin D. These three are interrelated. If in your body vitamin D is lacking, calcium and phosphorus, you are taking the food rich in calcium and phosphorus, but vitamin D will not get inside your body. Or if calcium phosphorus is inadequate and you are taking vitamin D sources of food, then only also you cannot, your body cannot get vitamin D. That means calcium phosphorus help vitamin D to go inside or get assimilated in your body, as well as vitamin D also helps to your body to calcium and phosphorus get assimilated in our body. So we get vitamin D from egg, milk, butter, okay. Now we have completed all the deficiency disease due to, first one, carbohydrate and protein. Second group, deficiency disease is due to different type of mineral, like 4 minerals, iron, calcium and phosphorus, then iodine. Then we discuss what are the deficiency disease is due to all vitamin, like vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C and vitamin D. So how will avoid such type of a deficiency disease in from our life? 3 things you have to remember. 1, balanced diet, which is very important. Balanced diet, if you take, then you can avoid deficiency disease from your life. 2, a healthy eating habit you have to adopt. That means whatever food you are taking, that should be a balance, that should be in a proper amount. Then 3 is the children. Generally, most of the children are suffering in deficiency disease. We should give children lot of milk and milk products. Apart from that, if you provide soft boiled rice, juice, or many type of food, like those are rich in protein, then you can avoid deficiency disease from your life. These are all about this chapter, food and health. Thank you. God bless you, students. Now, students, we have completed all the deficiency diseases due to different type of vitamin, mineral, carbohydrate, proteins. Now, I ask one question to you. You tell that answer. The question is like this. A student having swelling at neck region, can you tell what is the disease? And also you tell which type of mineral, lack of mineral, this disease occurs. The disease name is goiter, and the goiter disease is due to lack of iodine in our diet. This is the answer. So in this way, in your question, symptoms are explained in the question. So you have to remember the symptom of a different deficiency, and you have to write the vitamin or minerals name, and also in that another symptom, if you ask another symptom, then you can write also. Okay, another question you can tell. A child is a very lazy, lethargic, means is not inactive in our school. When in our game period, that child is not playing in the playground, always take rest during the game period. In which disease that child is suffering, and his eyes and body looks weak and pale.
Now you tell in which disease that child is suffering in. The child is suffered in anemia. Due to anemia, the child feel weak and body color is pale, is inactive, is not doing his physical work in the playground. Okay, so these are all about our this chapter, food and health. Okay.